From the University of Minnesota School of Music, my name is Emily Threinen, and I am here to provide you with a two-minute tip on how your movement can have an impact on your ensemble's sound. In our conducting, we tend to focus on the tempo, patterns, and size of our gestures when we work with our ensembles. These elements certainly are important and require attention when working on a piece of music, but they don't necessarily impact the sound itself. In this video, I'd like to give you three additional elements to consider that may have a positive impact on the sound of your ensemble. Number one, your breath. Your breath helps elicit their breath. Try not to simply take your breath, but instead breathe in a way that allows your musicians to inhale and exhale with their best lung support and thus producing their best tone on their instrument. Versus, or you can do it fast as well. Number two, your gestural follow-through, even flow of time, and quality of motion between the beats helps their air and tone. Think of your ensemble members' air always moving, and thus your baton or hand is also always moving, especially between the beats and in the patterns. Faster tempo, slower tempo, always fluid, versus so try to move with air even when it's fast tempo. When we think of gestures, we often focus mostly on our arms and hands. In addition, try to consistently activate your torso and lead your arms and hands with your heart center. Leading in this way may also help activate your face and eye contact with your musicians. To quote Shakespeare, eyes are the window to the soul, and thus I often think of my eyes, my tip of the baton, and their eyes, and connecting the three. Here's activating the torso. Activating the torso, adding the breath, and trying to move in that way. Here's now activating eyes, tip, eyes. To summarize, consider how your breath elicits their best breath. We want to move like their air, even in fast music, and thus we want to move with more fluidity between the beats and patterns. And finally, activate your torso. And consider connecting your torso, your eyes, your baton, and their eyes when communicating. I hope these ideas help reinforce concepts you are already familiar with or offer a new perspective. I wish you all the best in your music making and discovery. Thanks for watching.